that jail experience, I think I did over a year of that time. I stayed on that over a year because I had a son at the time, and I was trying to get back to working. You know, I wasn't selling drugs anymore. I was trying to get back to working so I can raise my son. So I tried to get a lawyer to take me inside the courtroom to get a tan cut. This particular time, the people was telling me, you know, Ronnie, you a lifer on weekend. You know, you're not going to get a tan cut. You know, man, the judge ain't going to want to hear what you got to say. But it was hard for me to get back in the courtroom, but eventually I did get back in the courtroom. I went through two lawyers, two black lawyers. I tried to hire. They couldn't get in there. But I eventually saw a white lawyer I hired, and I paid him double amount, which he was only charged $300. I paid him $600 to get me back in the courtroom. And I saw the same judge, the same prosecutor. All I wanted to do was get up and tell the judge my story so he could release my time. Because that was a long time. I mean, doing time. I was on what they call a double blade sentence, which I was doing time and on probation. You know, I could do probation on my head because I'm not a street guy, so I won't get in trouble, you know. But he listened to me, the judge, he put me on the stand, and he listened to me, and the prosecutor ridiculed me again. They didn't remember who I was until the judge asked, or the prosecutor asked the judge, do you remember Mr. Foster, the one that lied on the oath twice? Yes, it was me. I lied on the oath twice because I was scared and afraid. But this time I was telling the judge the truth because, like I said, I had a son. I was trying to get out and raise. And the judge, he listened to me, but this judge here come out of retirement. He never cut anybody time, especially weekend time. So I had to tell the judge and convince him, you know, Your Honor, you know, I've never been in jail in my life. I've never been in trouble in my life. And I've seen convicted felons convicted two or three times get more leniency than me, Your Honor. And the judge saw fit to give me some leniency. And he didn't let me go right then. He had me go out and do some more weekend time, which I was exhausted of doing weekend time. And, you know, like I said, police officers out there, they trusted me. You know, black and white, you know, they pretty much let me do what I want to do because they trusted me so much, you know. For us eating in the prison, I don't see how people eat that food in that prison. I never did eat in the prison, never once. People that know me will tell you, I never did use the bathroom. I never did do number two, never, in the bathroom, in the jail. I never did. I held it until I got out. You know, you couldn't hardly take showers in there. It was just an experience that I don't wish upon no one. And these guys keep going in and out of jail. I just don't understand.